All right, so just a few things everyone might have missed while the extremely entertaining hysteria and absurdity was going down with the impeachment process. The House passed a $1.4 trillion spending bill, which Trump is expected to sign, and it's expected to raise the national debt by about $500 billion, which, you know, at this point, who really cares? $500 billion is a drop in the bucket now, but still, this is unbelievably irresponsible, and as usual, both Democrats and Republicans have illustrated just how little they care. It's just a circus, so throw money around and have fun, I guess. But also, there was that one thing I was talking about yesterday, how the legal age of buying tobacco was raised to 21. That was in this spending bill. Now, why was that in a spending bill? Well, to make sure everyone obeys this new decree, they've allocated $18.5 million for each fiscal year from 2020 to 2024. Very good use of our funds, I would say. That overreaching, wildly overpowerful federal government is not cheap, and you and your kids' kids get to pay for it, and there's nothing you can do. The big one, though, is that there is about $740 billion in this spending bill for the Pentagon, and this will go to a whole host of wasteful nonsense, as that's how spending on the Pentagon usually goes, but it includes a 3% pay raise for military personnel, for a whole host of vehicle maintenance and supplies to maintain the U.S. empire overseas. And now I could just say the usual thing about how this is irresponsible, it doesn't make us safer, it's a waste of money, it's simply a way to pad the pockets of those in tight with the Department of Defense, and that's all well and good, but what really amplifies how wasteful and absurd this all is another little news story about the Afghanistan papers that we barely heard a whisper about due to the impeachment entertainment news cycle. And that story is how the war in Afghanistan has been revealed to be an utter abject failure, if that wasn't obvious enough already. In the so-called Afghanistan papers, it is revealed by Douglas Lute, a three-star army general, that, quote, "We were devoid of a fundamental understanding of Afghanistan, we didn't know what we were doing, and that we didn't have the foggiest notion of what we were undertaking." And he also put the blame on dysfunctional bureaucratic breakdowns in Congress for the deaths of military personnel. These papers also revealed that the government knew this war was unwinnable, and they outright lied about failures and passed them off as successes. I mean, this is 18 years of outright lies. Hundreds of thousands of people being sent to Afghanistan with no goal, over 2,000 Americans dying, an untold number of innocent people in Afghanistan dying from this. It's an unbelievable mountain of resources and wealth that were wasted on this, whipping more people up into a frenzy to hate the United States because of that euphemistically titled collateral damage, which is otherwise known as, whoops, we accidentally bombed and killed a bunch of innocent people. We couldn't tell friend from foe, and often funded psychopathic warlords. This list is endless. Military is a part of the government, as some people seem to forget sometimes, and my God, does it show. Horribly mismanaged, corrupt to the core, without focus, while the entire time you are forced to fund this mayhem. This should be the top news story of the past two decades, but no, what do we get? We get politicians foaming at the mouth over a ridiculous impeachment process, pretending they hate each other. And maybe they do, but when it comes to putting the screws to the average citizen, they work wonderfully together on that. I mean, when it comes to forcing you to pay for the most insane foreign policy the world might have ever seen at this point, they're two peas in a pod. When it comes to making sure that crater of debt gets dug deeper and deeper and that leveraged void becomes darker and darker, Republicans and Democrats were perfectly made for one another. Both parties are filled to the brim with irresponsible screaming little children, it seems. And again, you get to pay for it. You get to pay for the madness while they divert your attention to a circus impeachment sideshow. But that is it for now. Sub and share if you would, and take it easy.